Calvin Chastain at an always crowded North Pole Lane just outside of beautiful downtown Plattsburgh. It's the 18th day of January 2017. We were here earlier today, my wife Judy and I, to do a hometown story with the folks here, the Munson family at the North Bowl. But we're back now in the afternoon for CVAC High School Bowling. And we are usually in a crunch when we cover bowling, and today even more so, because when we leave here in Plattsburgh, we're rushing to Ellenburg for a projected 5:30 start on their wrestling. Modified wrestling will start sometime around 5:30, and we hope to be there not too long after that. So we're hoping to get in at least one game. Okay, I'm zooming in. All right, the warm-up speeches are going to take place here for the coaches. And it's going to start shortly after 3:30, so I might just luck out. As I was saying there, before Dave Coates, the coach came over, the Cougar coach came over to talk to me. We're rushing here to go to Ellenburg for wrestling, and we'll try to be as fair as we can to all of our Northern Tier schools and teams, and we want to catch Beekmantown and Northeastern here in the bowling, and we want to catch the Bobcat wrestling team at least once. Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to catch them against Beekmantown because of the way our schedule works out. But as you can see from the numbers here, Dave Coates and Danielle Tierney are the coaches, and that's their squad. And here's the squad over here for Peter Stone and Jim Garrett's team. Quite a few bowlers on the Beekmantown side. We're going to just give you the B names. I doubt if we're going to have time to switch over there too often, but we'll try. For the Eagles, Riley Rafalco, Ryan Northrup, Jacob Eldridge, Dalton Seymour, and Dylan Seymour. On the Cougar side, it's Matt Joliker. This is a different Matt Joliker than the fellow who graduated last year. Aiden Roberts, Jacob Jarrett, Greg Delisle, and Zach Catanzarita. And since we're reading off the names, we'll go right into the girls and boys teams for Beekmantown. Morgan Brunette for the Eagles, Alexis Cook, Kylie Hilborn, Cheyenne Reeves, and Eliza Agony. Seeing Morgan Brunette here kind of explains to me why I see Terry Brunette not too far away from me. He's one of the top bowlers in the region, and his son was one of the top CVAC bowlers just a couple of years ago. Also on the boys' side of Beekmantown, Jordan Dio, Jacob Dio. I'm wondering if those are Steve Dio's grandsons. I think I've seen Steve and Altona at a few of these over the years. Damian Stoltzman, Mitchell Trost, and Austin Recor. And the Cougar girls, only two Cougar girls here today, so it's an automatic 4-0 win for Beekmantown. Cassidy Nixon and Sabrina Fair. For the A boys for the Cougars, you've got Josh McGoldrick, Hunter LeBlanc, Tyler Lappin, Nate Catanzarita, and Gabe Sisko. So them's your bowlers. We see bowlers from Chateauguay. I see some black shirts over there. That's probably Plattsburgh High School over to our left. They try to squeeze them in here and get as many teams as they can. And this is a Wednesday. The bowling alley is tied up on Thursday afternoons, so there isn't always room for high school bowling on Thursday, so they have a very tight schedule. One of the problems that we pointed out in the past in doing the bowling here is at the bowl mark and Rouse's Point, outside of Rouse's Point, we were elevated about 5 or 6 feet over the top of the bowlers. Here, we are just one step up, maybe two steps up, maybe a foot and a half above the bowlers. So we get a lot of people standing in front of us, and We do have problems in seeing also the lighting. The area where we're standing and where the boulders are is dark, and the area where the alley is lighter, much lighter, so that gives a little bit of a problem. So Fair, we'll start with Fair here, counting names, as we had Nixon, not sure what she did. We got a 1-2-4 for Fair. Nixon, wow, that's small writing. Okay, that's why, she had she missed her spare. The award's Fair, and as we stay here for this first spare, we're up to Tyler Lappin for the Cougars on the boys' side, and that was Trost, Mitchell Trost for Beekmantown. Over here in the girls for the Eagles, we've got Ricor and Brunette. Here we got Nate Catanzarita getting 7 pins. We've got Trost going for his spare. Looks like maybe a strike for Brunette. He's a 10 pin. That was Ricor who maybe had a strike. Catanzarita is about to throw his bill as spare, potential spare. And it looks like he got it. And that gives us to Austin Ricor, Beekmantown. These strikes. There's Agony. Agony with a strike. And Brunette looking for the 10 pin. And she picks it up. Now we have Cisco for the Cougar boys. And he picks up a strike. Nixon for the Cougar girls. He leaves the 6-10. Now Cook for Beekmantown girls. He leaves just a 2-pin. And we got Dio, one of the Dios here. This is the fifth Dio, so this will be Jordan Dio. Beekmantown, he's got himself a strike. He had a spare. Nixon going for her spare. She will pick it up. Here's Josh McGoldrick. He has a strike. Now Cook going for her spare. She misses it. The other Dio, Jacob Dio, leaves a 7 pin. There we had Fair getting 6 pins. And here we have for the Cougars, Hunter LeBlanc. On our right, picking up the spare was Dio, getting 9 pins on her first ball was Hillborn. Fair picks up most of her spare, leaves 10 pin. LeBlanc. And over here is Stotzman, I guess. I'll show you David Coates' handwriting here so you can see what I'm trying to do. Ooh, nice spare by Tyler Lappin. We have Reeves for Beekmantown. And she gets a dangling 10 pin to fall. And following Reeves, we have the Trost following Stoltzman. Here's Catanzarita for the Cougars. Leaves the 3-10, baby split, Agony for Beekmantown girls. And there's Trost, leaves 8 pins. Over on this side, it's Brunette. She She got, I think, 9 pins on her first ball. And a missed spare for Captain Zarita. I'll have Nixon for the girls, for the Cougars, Trost, no recoil for the boys, for Beekmantown. Leaves a 7 pin, Nixon leaves the 3-6-10. And we have a spare by Brunette. And a strike by Gabe Sisko. Here's Recorp trying to pick up the 7 pin. He will pick it up. And we got Nixon. She will pick up her spare. Now Cook for Beekmantown. She picks up a strike. Gets us to Jordan Deal for the Eagles. And Josh McGoldrick for the Cougars. As Fair steps up for the Cougars. Fair will go first. Top of Charlie Stone's head, we see 9 pins knocked down. Now McGoldrick. He gets 8 pins, and we've got to mention McGoldrick's grandparents, Roy and Mary Clark, sitting in front of us. They're fine viewer supporters of Hometown Cable. And looking over the list of names here, I think they're the only ones who are currently supporting Hometown Cable. The players involved today, families involved. Fair misses her spare. McGoldrick. McGoldrick misses his spare, and I think she got hers over here. Yep, she did. Here's Deal, the other Deal, Jacob, getting 9 pins. So that was... this is Reeves, I guess. I've been reading her name as Rico off the back of her shirt as Reeves. My apologies. The only Rico we have is, oh, we got a 7-10 split coming up for Reeves. A great opportunity for a deal to pick up his spare. LeBlanc has, I think, 3 pins to pick up. Here is Brunette. Brunette leaves the 10 pin. Stokesman. Beekmantown, here's Reeves. First time we've ever picked up a 7-10 split right here, right now. It's, no. Sooner or later. That is a nice spare for LeBlanc. And Brunette, the 9 pin is Trost. He gets a late drop on the 10 pin for a strike. Lapham now for the Cougars. And agony over on the far side. And we actually have a break in the action here for a moment now. Record. He left a 3-6-10 wall. Agony will miss her spare. And so will the big guy, Lapham. Cook gets 6 men. She leaves that 1-3-6 wall. Recor misses his spare. Or is that his first ball? No, he missed his spare. Here's Captain Zarita throwing his first ball. He strikes. And Nixon, she strikes. You can see why I don't really have the opportunity much more than just a glance once in a while toward the bees, is that they'll try to cover the bees. Cook leaves the, probably the 3 pin. Sisko gets up another strike. Oop, zooming in on him here. That's a turkey, so he's got 3 in a row. Good way to start the game. McGoldrick We got a 12410, 12410. It's not a zip code. That's a strike for fair. And there's Dio. Jordan Dio getting 9 pins. McGoldrick going for his spare. It's a doable one. Not an easy one, but a doable one. Left at 10 pin. Cook probably is Dio, missing his spare. Hunter LeBlanc for the Cougars. And LeBlanc picks up 7 pins. Reeves, he strikes. Dio, a strike for Jacob Dio. I'll bring up Seymour, not Seymour. Oh, Seymour, yes, he's a b-bowler. All right. LeBlanc misses his spare, and Brunette over here gets 7 pins on her first ball. Now you got Stoltzman, let me zoom in on his name here. Oh, I guess I didn't get there in time. He's got a 4-7-10 agony. Leaves a 3-10. Brunette, missed her spare. And at Lapham. And Stoltzman. Agony. Let me give you a quick shot here. This is Stoltzman. You decide. There's he's a 7-pin. Looks like an open for Lapham. Tross is going to hit a strike for the Eagles. Nixon now for the Cougars. Catan Zarita up and Cook over there for the Eagle Girls, looking for his spare. She misses it. Catan Zarita will leave a, looks like a 3-6-10. And 1-2-4-10 left for Recor. There's a strike. That's Hilborn, I think. That was Hilborn. I think Hilborn's the one that, I can't read her name because her hair is covering her back. Nixon will miss her spare by that much. And looks like a spare over there for... there's a strike. That was a spare for Recor. Here's Fair. She strikes. Cisco. Oh, got himself a big, late drop on the four. Missed the 4-6 opportunity. He only has a 6-pin. McGoldrick gets a strike and shakes his head. I don't know how it happened, but it happened. Brunette with a strike. Agony now. The girls, obviously, with fewer bowlers, are moving along faster. Agony gets 7 pins. Cisco misses his spare, as does LeBlanc. And we've got Cook and Agony. And who's going to go first? Lapham over on our far side. Looks like they're going about the same time. Miss Bear and Lapham gets seven pins. And well, we got a strike here. Strike here for one of the Leo boys and a spare for Cook. Now we have Nixon. Nixon leaves a 3-6-10. The second deal gets leaves a looks like the two pin. Missed spare for. Lapham, and I think Milbourne missed her spare. Here's Nixon. She picks hers up. Reeves now for Beekmantown. Leaves a 10 pin. Katan Zarita leaves a 6-7-10. Similar opposite thing over here for the Beekmantown bowler. Fair gets eight pins. Bowling for the Eagles is. Let's see. We're gonna get his name here. Stutzman. Nice pick up there by Katan Zarita. And getting most of the pins with Stutzman. We got Trost, we got Cisco, and over here we've got Fair. Picking up his spare is Trost, only a couple of them. Cisco, strike. He's got a bunch of those this game, doesn't he? Now Agony and Brunette. Here's Agony. She strikes. Brunette. Leaves a 3-10. Trost picks up his spare. So we got Nixon for the Cougars. And Brunette. Nixon leaves the two pin. And Recor, he strikes. And Brunette picks up her spare. Dio now, this is the first one, Jordan.
Again, Morgan.
Now we got Nixon. Getting ready for the Cougar girls and the Bobrick for the Cougar boys. Nixon picks up her spare. The Bobrick. Spare and over here, leaving the 7 pin is the Jacob deal. This has to be Hilborn, since I can't see her name. And she strikes. Now LeBlanc. LeBlanc leaves just the 4 pin. Deal going for the spare, will pick it up. And we got Reeves They got double wood. Looks like the 3-9. Even the 7-pin here is Stutzman. We got a strike for a spare here for LeBlanc. And a missed spare over here. For Beekmantown, we have Brunette and Agony now. And Brunette, Stutzman misses his spare. Lapham for the Cougars. And a strike over there for Beekmantown by Agony. Brunette will pick up her spare. Ooh, baby split for Trost.
Morgan.
A 4-5, I don't know what that is. There's Nixon. It's a strike. There's Lapham missing his spare. Cook. And she gets a strike. And 9-pins over there, fair. Leaves just the 4-pin. Well, that was a toss. He didn't pick up his spare. Here's Captain Zarita. Captain Zarita leaves the 4-pin. There's Coburn. Leaves double wood. Fair. Missed it. Recor leaves a 7-pin. Captain Zarita now. And he picks it up. Hilborn looking for the double wood. He's got to hit this pretty much dead on. And he missed it. There's Recor going for that 7-pin. He missed it. I saw the pin duck out of the way when the ball was coming. What? Cisco up for the Cougar boys. Here's Reeves for the girls. Beekmantown. She needs it. 4-7. Cisco. Eight strikes. Gotta check his score here. He must have a decent score. Alma Goldrick. Could have been worse. Could have been worse. Let's see. Looks like we're heading into the ninth frame for the girls. The boys are wrapping up the sixth frame, starting the seventh. Here's Dio. He gets a strike. Doesn't know why. Just shakes his head. Says, I don't know how I do it. Just, that's amazing. And McGoldrick, he covers it. So Jacob Dio following Jordan's strike says, hey, I know how you did it. There you go. Now I know. You get one Dio watching the other and he'll figure it out here. Now LeBlanc for the Cougars. And he strikes. How about that? Reeves picks up her spare. Brunette starting the ninth frame here, I guess. And she strikes. Now Stutzman gets 9 pins. Agony up for the Eagle girls. Lapham for the Cougar boys. And Agony. He's a 10 pin and Lapham leaves a 1-2-4, a strike over that away for Cook. I didn't see what Stutzman did. It looks like he got it. Now Agony got a 10 pin. Cook did not get a strike. She's got a 10 pin standing up there. Agony picks it up. There, there, and miss there, there. So Lapham picks up his, and Cook misses hers. Now bring up Nixon and Billborn, and over here with Trost. Trost just threw a strike, did he? Oh, no, he got nine pins. Nixon, she strikes. Catan Zarita leaves a 10 pin. Billborn leaves a 10 pin. Trost picks up his spare. Almost had double pinnacle, but it's just 4-6-10. The 10 went down. Catan Zarita will miss his 10 pin. Billborn picks up her spare and Trost knocks them all down. Here's Fair. She misses her 4-6, I think she got a 7 or something. It was Cisco. And can't knock them down all the time, every time. The Goldwick. And the gutter, Brunette. Now Brunette might be starting the 10th frame here. It's 9 in her first ball. She's in the 10th. Reeves, spares. Cisco, spares. Brunette needs a spare to get a fill ball. And she will get it. Now the Goldwick up for the Cougars. Goldrick with a strike. Oh, not a strike, it's a 10-pin spare. He had, for that, he had that gutter ball. There's Deal. Agony. And Brunette with a fill ball here. She'll get 9 on her fill ball. A little glance up at her total. As a bomb, gets 8 pins. Dio picks up the 7 pin. Agony picks up her spare for 180 for Brunette. Cup. LeBlanc leaves a 7. Give it a shot. Deal and Nixon. Nixon gets, leaves double wood. Deal gets 7 pins. We got Cook going for her spare. She'll get a fill ball. We're going to make sure we get the girls, so we miss the boy here and there, because the girls are wrapping up their first game. Lapham, it's 8 pins. Nixon looking for a fill ball with a double wood. She gets the double wood. Nice job. Now Cook. He's a 6-10 and her, with her fill ball, so that doesn't matter what she left. Lapham picks up his spare. Stutzman strikes, and over here Nixon with a fill ball will get a 10. So let's see what we're at here. Nixon, he gets a 180. Hey, nothing to sneeze at there. And over here a 133 for Cook. Zarita gets 6-7 pins. Fair gets a strike to start the 10th. Tross looks like he just struck. There's Hilborn for Beekmantown. And she will not get a fill ball. Her first game is over. Then Zarita will miss his spare, leaves the 6-10. Here's Fair with her first of two fill balls. She has 9 pins. And over this way, Trost. Recor. The struck. Cisco up for the Kubu. He's a 6-10. Here's Fair's last ball, and it will be good. And we'll give her a 155. So pretty good totals there for the Cougar girls. Now Goldrick, she just struck. Over here on the Beekmantown side, we've got the four girls that have finished up. Or three girls. Brunette, the 180, 133 for Cook, Hilborn, a 163. Now we've got Reeves. And Cisco just picked up his spare. Reeves with a strike. And we got Jordan Dio now. Strikes. Hunter LeBlanc for the Cougars. I gotta check out the Dio's score one of these times too. LeBlanc gets 8 pins. Well, what happened? Reeves finished up apparently, because here's Agony. Reeves, a 190. I don't know if I saw her throwing those or if I was distracted here. Very difficult to distract me. I'm so focused. Agony gets 6 pins. Here's Dio. Jacob Dio gets 8 pins. LeBlanc has the 4-8. And he'll get the 8, not the 4. Right now, Cheyenne Reeves has a spare. 190 is a high for the girls in this first game. Boys are wrapping up the 8th. They'll be starting the 9th. Well, they've started the 9th. Yes, they've started the 9th, apparently. There's LeBlanc. Dio gets 9 pins. Agony. The fill ball. And a strike. Nice way to end the game. Give her a 185. So you got some good totals there for Beekmantown. 851 total. The Cougars are just two bowlers out of the 335. We'll concentrate on the boys, and I guess we'll have to check the score here. It's a pretty close game at the moment. 678 to 660. This is the A boys, and there's an open for Stutzman, Katan Zarita. Oh, baby split. It's the 8-9, I think. Baby split Trost for Beekmantown. And Trost will leave 7-10. 7-10, all right, I got to get position here to pick up that first ever 7-10. Katan Zarita will go first there. You got a baby split. Frost has the real He-Man split there, not a little baby split. And a field goal for Katan Zarita as a sign. There we go, first ever 7-10 split on hometown cable is... No, not this time. Not this time.
Yeah, really. Move back.
Alright, we are going pretty much through this Cisco, 4-6-7. Or 4-7-6 if you prefer. And a strike for Ricor. Well, we'll check them. They get set for the 10th here. Cisco gets an open after so many nice things here. 6-6, 677, 742. So Beekmantown has opened it up as we go into the 10th. Josh McGoldrick leads the 2-pin. Jordan Deal. Leads the 3-pin. That's the wrong side. Here's McGoldrick. Okay, so this is McGoldrick here. He'll get a fill ball. Deal will miss his spare after all those nice strikes throughout the game here. Number 163, McGoldrick has a 140 plus. Plus, 10. So that was plus 20 actually, because he had his 10 and a 10th and then the fill ball. Jacob Deal gets 6 pins. He's a 1-3-6-7. LeBlanc up for the Cougars. 760 to 707 right now, team score. He gets, LeBlanc gets 6 pins, and Dio, and the Dubois got the 1, oh, he didn't get that 7 pin, so he's going to have an open. He gets a 160, LeBlanc has an open. Stutzman. He strikes. Well, let's see here. Team wise, 779, Beekmantown, 715, Cougars. Lapham. He gets 8 pins, 7 pins, 9 pins, and leaves just the 6. Stutzman with his first of 2 fill balls. And he leaves a 7. There's Lapham. So for the Cougars, 160 for McGoldrick, Hunter LeBlanc, 144, 122 for Lapham, and Stutzman picks up his spare, so we give him a 171. The high man at the moment, on the board at least, is Katan Zarita getting a strike. Gonna 122 for Lapham, one Cross, at least 710s, he's a 3610.
Oh, good guy.
Oh, a 6-7s, but it's not much fun as a 710. There's a spare for Trost. There's Catan Zalita going for his 6-7 split. That would have got the crowd excited, huh? And leaving the 10 pin on his fill ball was Trost. Well, Trost ends up with a 162. Beekmantown bowlers all pretty much bunched in there. Recor. Recor leaves a 3-6. Strike for Cisco. The team scores for the Cougars 7-53 as Catan Zalita ends up with a 145. Trost, meantime, picks up his spare as
well. Scores for the Chattanooga Bulldogs. Matthew Carr, personal best, 227.
There we go.
Blaine Nichols, 216. And from the Boston Hornets, Jesse Schaefer, 233. Good going.
Martin.
Ricor. Ricor gets a strike. That was Ricor. Cisco gets another strike.
Wow.
Alright, let's see what we got here. Okay, Ricor finishes with a team high 190. Team is 846. There's your Beekmantown scores. There's your Cougar scores. And a possible 200 game here for Cisco. Get there, did he? 197. A nice game, but when you're that close, you want to hit that 200 mark. So 768 to 846. The Bees are still in their first game, but we have got to head for Ellenberg. We've got wrestling starting, and we want to get there in a timely manner. We'll zoom in here to see what the figures in on the 566 to 679. So that's Beekmantown scores here. Looks like Beekmantown is finished up here. 117 for Falco, 132 for Northrop, 160 for Eldridge, and we've got Dalton Seymour bowling right now over on the Cougar side. We've got 100 for Matt Joliker, a 99 for Aiden Roberts. There's a whole bunch of pins to pick up there. Then a 138 for Jacob Jarrett. Greg Delisle with a 78. And he just finished his game, I think. Delisle. Right here. And Greg Delisle. Greg Delisle just finished in 95, so Jake and Jared at 138. And Zach Tapizadita is up now. He had three strikes in a row there, so he's got a decent total going in. So we'll wrap up with Zach Catanzarita and call it a day here at the North Bowl. Looks like he's waiting for his ball. It happens once in a while. We just might have to we're waiting for the pin setter, I guess. Zach Catanzarita. That was a strike. He's going to get two fill balls here, so he's got a 171. That wasn't him. Those are the extra bowlers over that way. Or not. No, that was a... No, I don't know who that was. It must have been an extra bowler. You have the A team, B team, and you got extras. A six pin. Oh. 71. He's got 181, doesn't he? 190 now. I think he's got a 190 here. That's this one. Missed it. I only had a 180. Okay, I didn't know if they put that strike in on the 161 or not, but obviously if they put the 161 up there, then I have to include the strike. So 612 total to a 737 total. So that's the way it was in CVAC High School Bowling, Beekmantown, and Northeastern Clinton coming at you from the North Bowl lanes. And just outside of beautiful downtown Plattsburgh. And I want to thank those of you who are watching, and particularly the ones of you who are supporting Hometown Cable. Viewer supported local television, Hometown Cable. The only reason we can be here is because very few of you step up to the plate and support this program. And if you'd like to see it continue in the future, we really do need you to step up and help keep our efforts rolling. Thank you again for watching.